Mr. Speaker, I am glad to speak a few words on the education demand. Many honorable members have spoken on it, so I do not propose to refer to the points mentioned by them. However, I will speak about the quality of education provided in the schools and colleges at the present. Many of the students who pass out of the educational institutions are now finding it very difficult to get a job under government or any private organization. I think the education received by them in schools and colleges now does not perhaps help them to secure jobs. We must carefully consider the reasons for the present situation. In my view, the syllabus for the various courses of study should be suitably changed, consisting of educationists, industrialists, and representatives of government should be set up. This committee should examine the present syllabus and find out whether it suits the present day demands of government, private organizations, and other agencies which recruit staff for their respective offices. If not, the committee may suggest necessary modifications in the syllabus, keeping in view the needs of society, industries, private organizations, government departments, etc. If this done and the students are taught as per the new syllabus suggested by the committee, it will enable the students to get a suitable job under any one of the organizations. Apart from securing suitable jobs, the courses of study should also equip the students with the necessary knowledge and training to start a small industry themselves. If this is done, the students can start their own industry in case they are not able to get a job. In this connection, I would like to suggest that the government can help those who want to start their own business in a number of ways. They can create favorable conditions such as making it easy for them to get the necessary license, making technical advice available to them, and also making it possible for them to get the required finance from banks. The government should also come forward to offer more scholarships to deserving students. At the present, a number of students are not able to acquire higher knowledge as they are poor and cannot afford to study in postgraduate courses if they are given necessary assistance many of them will acquire higher degrees with these few words I conclude my speech thank you letter from raman and company madurai to messrs murugan enterprises koilpatti dear sirs we have received your letter of the 10th instant we are sorry to note that you will not be able to supply the items covered by our order dated the 1st instant you have given two reasons for this one is lack of transport facilities due to the strike of lorry owners the second reason is that there was some delay in our settlement of your previous bills we are prepared to transport the goods through our own lorry we have already explained in our earlier letter that the delay in payment was due to causes beyond our control we have since cleared all your bills if you can supply the items now we shall send 50% of the cost in advance and send a check for the balance in 2 weeks under the circumstances we expect your reply by return of post yours faithfully thank you இந்த ஆடியோ உங்களுக்கு பிடிச்சிருந்தா லைக் பண்ணுங்க கமெண்ட் பண்ணுங்க ஷேர் பண்ணுங்க மறக்காம சப்ஸ்கிரைப் பண்ணுங்க தேங்க் யூ ஸோ மச்